Hi, I'm Stefan. I'm one of the developers here at Code Institute. Today, I'm going to talk to you about JavaScript. But before we do that, please subscribe, like, and share. JavaScript is a programming language. It is a scripting language that lets us control multimedia within our web pages. It empowers a developer to do many things like adding animation to our images or updating content automatically on the page. For example, if you're on a web page that has a shopping cart powered by JavaScript, you'll notice that it immediately shows the total cost of what you want to buy, including taxes, shipping, etc. JavaScript is then used when determining whether the credit card details you entered were valid before actually transferring those details across the net to the bank for processing. JavaScript is now the language of the web. For years, it was only run in browsers to operate on HTML. Now, it also runs on servers and is as powerful as many of the other programming languages you'll encounter. JavaScript is among the world's most used programming languages now. Without it, we'd be looking at pages that do nothing other than display images and text. So while CSS may be what offers style to a website, JavaScript is what gives it life. JavaScript is what allows you to interact with the vast majority of web pages that you'll visit. Whether it's filling out forms, scrolling through maps, or registering for an event, it's most likely that JavaScript is what is allowing you to do that. It's vitally important for all industries, especially since we're now in an age where data is power. While it's not the JavaScript that holds all of this data, it is what allows it to be manipulated in the browser. It's the language that creates the functions needed to interact with a company through its website. JavaScript enables users to fill out forms, click buttons, and more. Without it, businesses would be at a significant loss. Web browsers are built to understand HTML and CSS and convert those languages into a visual display on the screen. To do this, the browser uses what's called a layout or a rendering engine. This is the part of the web browser that understands HTML and CSS. A browser also contains what's called a JavaScript interpreter. This is the part of the browser that understands JavaScript and can execute the steps of the JavaScript program. A web browser is usually expecting HTML, but we must specifically tell the browser when JavaScript is included. To do this, we use the script tag. This is similar to the style tag used in CSS. Also like CSS, JavaScript can be included in the head element or accessed from an external file. JavaScript doesn't have to be confined to the head element though. You can also insert script elements in the body area, creating islands of behavior or functionality throughout the page. Developers often recommend that you place your JavaScript as the last element inside the body of a page. This is because JavaScript mainly operates on HTML elements as part of a task. JavaScript is designed to be able to travel the element family tree or DOM and access, modify, add, or even delete elements. If the JavaScript appears in the head of a page, it might attempt to access elements that a browser has not yet interpreted. That is, they might not yet have been added to the family tree in memory. These elements need to have first been read by the browser interpreter for JavaScript to access them on the tree. Learning a programming language is like learning any spoken language. There are words to learn and rules to be followed. For example, if you wanted to learn Spanish, you would have to learn the grammatical rules before you can speak it fluently. So with JavaScript, there are grammatic type rules that you will have to learn. Once you know the fundamentals of one programming language, you know many of the fundamentals of all. JavaScript allows us to interact with the document object model directly. In our example, we access the document object. When a developer loads an HTML document into the web browser, it's at the stage that it becomes a document object. So looking at our previous example that we did in our CSS video, I'm going to add our JavaScript to the same file now. And as I mentioned before, we can either add it in the head or in the body. In this instance, I'm just going to add it to the body. So I'm going to add my script tag here. And then what I will want to do to demonstrate our JavaScript interpreter is I'm just going to write some text using JavaScript. So what I'll say is document.write, which will just write out content onto the web page. And I'm just going to say this is written using JS and terminate it with a semicolon. So now if I open our web page in the browser, we can see here our writing. And if I refresh the page, you can see now this is written using JavaScript. The document object is the root node of the HTML document and the owner of all other nodes or elements. The document object provides properties and methods to access all node objects within JavaScript. In our example, we use the document object to write to the screen. JavaScript uses what is called dot notation. On the left, we see a word called document. This word represents the document object, both to the developer and the browser. A dot then follows it, then another word with parentheses and some text inside the parentheses. Everything after the dot is called a function. A function does something. The name tells us what the function does. In this case, it will write something to the screen. The text inside the parentheses is what will be evaluated and written to the screen. This illustrates JavaScript's ability to work with and even create HTML elements on the fly. And secondly, to perform tasks such as mathematical operations. Notice that this content is added dynamically. That is, when the page is created, there are no elements inside the body tags. Only when the page is run in a browser does the JavaScript run. If you want to learn some of the basics for free, then try our 5-day coding challenge. After just 1 hour a day for 5 days, you will have built your first ever web page. Register today and take your first steps in becoming a coder.